Alrighty, boys and girls, we're going to be playing some Lantern Control tonight. Let's see what we can hit in terms of competition tonight. Let's see if we get anything good. So, match number one. And I'll put up my little deck list so you all can see what I'm playing. Again, provided by the virtualdecklist.com. I think it's pretty cool. Alright, looks like we got a couple of people viewing the stream already. So, not a good way to start out tonight. Gonna mull that. What is this? Just anti-land knight? Okay, well. It's something. A swamp on top. I guess that'll work so I can cast my Inquisition and surgically extract something. So we'll just pass and see what's going to happen. Oh, it's Tron. Okay. Well. So. Not exactly how I wanted to start out tonight. Let's see if it's Tron or some Ooh, yuck. Okay. Well. So. Map a reshaper, a ballista. Do the ballista and just get surgically extract that and see what all he's got, I guess. Goodbye. See what kind of build this is. Oh, Basilisk Collar version. Okay. See, we've got some Endbringer. Ooh, yeah, this is full-on Eldrazitron. Don't have to worry too much about the Basilisk Collar. But Chalice of the Void is going to suck. Okay. So, we know what we're up against. Ghost Quarter. We'll play our Ghost Quarter with a throw at the bell. But I not want to wait until their draw step to surgical the ballista. It's not such a big thing. I could do it whenever. Since it was the very first thing of the game, I don't think it's such a big deal. But, yeah, I guess I could have seen another card. And he grabbed an Eldrazi Temple. Okay. Two, three, four. So this is going to be a Thought Knot. No, no, wait. It's going to be the Reshaper. Which is fine. And another map. Well, should I go ahead and bell this? I think I'll wait. Let's see what I grab. Probably should have built. Okay. So nothing much going on yet. Let's go ahead and bell during the upkeep. I'll get rid of the Reshaper, get rid of my Inquisition. And is this going to be... Yep, here comes the Smasher. This is going to hurt. Alright, need a bridge. Like, fast. There's a Crucible, which is kind of fun. Getting the saltiness already out of the way. Alright. So we'll just pass the turn. Oh, no, you're good. I've only been playing Lantern for a couple weeks now, so all good. Oh, there's a Thought Knot. That works. Let's sack this Ghost Quarter, take care of the temple, so he can't do any more Eldrazi craziness. So he grabs a Waste. So at least he can't cast another Smasher. Cracks the map. Yeah, this whole Crucible of the Worlds thing is pretty nice. Well, we're done. It's pretty nice against Tron because you can just keep repeating your Ghost Quarters. And, yep, you got a Smasher. Okay, so against Tron. Lost Legacy is good because I can name Tron or Ugin or pretty much anything besides an artifact or a land. What else do I want to get rid of? Tron. We could Nature's Claim a piece of his. Seal of Primordium seems okay. Don't need to worry about Padim because he's not going to be able to destroy our stuff. Leyline's not important. Battle at the Bridge is fun, but not needed here. So we will go down. Keep Abrupt Decay in just because. I'll go down the Baubles, and I'll go down. Go down the Inquisition because a lot of his stuff is over three. So let's try this. And, okay. Well, he must not want to play. Yeah, Eldrazitron is not a great matchup for us. But dude scoop, so whatevs. Let's go to the next matchup. Let's see what we get. Oh, we've got a Lantern. We've got a Shredder. We got a Needle. Oh, this is nice. And a Bridge. So we have our lock in hand. Let's start out with the Marsh, throw out the Opal, throw out the Lantern. Let's see what we're up against. Oh, is this some kind of either Delver or Storm? If it's Storm, I'm really not looking forward to it. Let's see. Oh, Fatal Push, pointless. Oh, this is probably Delver if he's got black. So Grixis Delver, which is fine. Let's throw out the Black Cleaves. Let's throw out our Shredder. So that turns our Opal on, maybe. Unless he fetches for an island and tries to counter it. Oh, we're up to 5 viewers. All right. Yep, feel free to chat if you want to or comment on my place because I'm a new player, so in terms of Lantern. Yeah, that hand was pretty lovely. So what's he going to do? Is he Thought Scour? Okay. Oh, K-Command. I'm going to love shredding that. Let's Pithing Needle. And let's name Tassiger. And we will just go ahead and shred away that K-Command. Oh, of course. Well, at least if he goes after something now, it'll be probably the Shredder or the Lantern. and I can still play the bridge. Ancestral Visions, Serum Visions. So he needs a black source to be able to cast the K command. So maybe I can keep him off the black source. There's a Flooded Strand. That can fetch a black source. I can get that Water of Grave. Okay. So we'll throw out our Inventor's Fair, and I'll keep the Ensnaring Bridge in hand at the moment. I'll go ahead and shred that Flooded Strand. He still needs black. He's got a Counter Squall, but that's good. Pass a turn. And let's see, does he have the black mana? No, he does not. So we got rid of a Creeping Tar Pit, got rid of a Flooded Strand. There's a Cryptic. Can't cast it, which is fine. Alright, we'll draw the Needle. Throw out our Spire, draw the Needle. I mean, go for the Needle, and let's go ahead and name Polluted Delta. So you can't, one less thing to fetch black mana with. Because I think they run, what, one black source, if I remember. Hey, Thinker. Back to watch more punishment. He bolts me. Okay, whatever. Cryptic. I think I'm okay with him drawing Cryptic at the moment, as long as we keep him off lands. There's a Scalding Tarn. Ah, nice. Cockatrice Games. Yep. Alright, we're going to shred that Tarn. Because we're going to keep him off. Throw a Polluted Delta. He can have that. Natals have named so far Tassiger and Polluted Delta. So we're trying to keep him off the black mana. Alright, we'll draw another Lantern. Yeah, because I know he's got a K command in hand. So as long as I can keep him off that black mana, I think we've got the game pretty well in hand. Ancestral Visions, got one more. Oh, there's a Tarn. Gotta be slowly running out of these Tarns. That's one, two, three. This'll be the third one. Oh, his fourth one's gonna be on our upkeep. So that just leaves him with Flooded Strand. So his only outs are he's got one Flooded Strand in the graveyard. If he runs four, he's got three of those left and one basic swamp, I'm guessing. Ugh, there's a Creeping Tar Pit. That's not going to work. Well, I'll make him shuffle that away. We'll draw our swamp. Good heavens, we're getting flooded with all sorts of mana at the point. So I think this is Ancestral coming through today, right now. Oh, he drew his lone basic swamp. Ugh. Where's a ghost quarter when I need it? Okay, let's see if he K-commands something. No K-command yet. See, I don't really want this grove. He has to pitch some stuff. Sort of a counter squall. I know he's not getting cryptic. I'm not worried about that per se. Exactly. So I think we're in pretty decent shape. Tasker is gonna suck, but I've got that bridge in hand, so we're okay there. Let's shred ourselves because I don't want that grove. Need another shredder. Inquisition. I guess it could be worse. Exactly, yeah, he needs to hit that pithing needle. I could just fetch up another pithing needle. Yep, hitting the needle. And I'm discarding a card, okay. Because he saw that Inquisition coming, so he's gonna get. He knew I was gonna go after that K command. I think. Let's see what he has got in his hand with an Inquisition. Counter Squall, Snapcaster, Snapcaster, and a Polluted Delta. So. Get rid of the counter squall, I guess. And next turn, I guess we just pull up another needle. Alright, let's see what he fetches with the Delta. Should be like a watery grave, I would think. Yep. Here comes the Banana Man. And he's got enough up for Cryptic. So, that's not cool. Alright, does Inquisition do me any good based on what's left his hand? He's got two Snapcasters left. Yeah, I'm gonna wait to throw out the fair until I get a bridge. I have to shred her because I don't think this Inquisition is gonna do anything. Well, let's think about it. If he's got a Snapcaster, he could bring back K command again, but he's got two Snapcasters in hand. What I really need is my Academy Ruins. Yeah, I think I gotta draw the Inquisition. Yep, and what's he going to do? Counter squall? Yep. Fun. Okay. Hmm. Hi, Monobolts. We're hurting a little bit right now. We're going to take 6. He leaves it up. Well, let's shred away his. Okay, so if he pulls another Snapcaster, we're going to be taking 8 next turn. Do I get rid of the bauble? Yeah, let's get rid of the bauble. An opal. Well, that does nothing. Okay. Well, we're hurting at the moment. There's a bridge. Let's just throw this out. I'm not doing anything with it. Okay, well, Let's just shred his cryptic. He's playing Snapcaster, yep. What's he targeting back? His serum visions. Yeah, I'd love to sack the fair for a bridge, but. Oh, he thought scours, okay. He thought scours to a cryptic. Okay. Oh, he got rid of a K command. Now he's got terminate. I don't care. Oh, I've got an infernal tutor. Well, we'll take our beats. Wonder, can I fare for a bridge? And then if I don't get that, I can infernal tutor and grab another bridge? I think that is almost the play I can do. Because he's only got one cryptic left in hand. He can't go around 2. So, I think that's what we do. We sack that. Yeah, that scared me to get rid of a bridge, but there I've got 4, and there's only 2 in the graveyard. Yeah. Well, I guess he can bounce a bridge with cryptic, can't he? Yeah, return target to permanent hand. So he's got 1, 2. Unless he gets a K command. Oh, there's another ensnaring bridge on top. Ugh, I'm not going to have enough mana for that, though. Yeah. I was 1 mana short. We'll just concede. All right, game 2. All right, for this matchup, Cage seems okay. Lost Legacy seems okay. Padim seems kind of okay, because then he can't bounce our bridges or anything, or can't do K-Command, so that sounds pretty good. So, let's try that. Let's get rid of our baubles, which seem horrible. Pithing Needle doesn't do much, so we can drop one of those down to 3. I mean, it's good for shutting off Tassiger, I guess, and good for shutting off his fetch lands, but I forgot he had that second cryptic in hand. Yep. Let's see, what other should we go down? Let's go down. Collective Brutality hits Cryptic Command and is instant and sorceries. Let's go down. I guess an Abrupt Decay. Why do I have Sun Droplet over more Leyline? 2 Leylines are good. I have been considering a third, but Sun Droplet is just so good against aggro. So, yeah, Sun Droplet is the way to go if you're playing against any kind of aggro or burn deck. I would play first. Oh, we have a Needle. We have a... Ooh, this is actually pretty okay. We don't have a Lantern, but we can tutor for a Lantern. Got an early bridge. I think we're okay with this. We can pull off something with Thoughtseize. So, Marsh to Thoughtseize. Oh, Collective Brutality, Ceremonious Rejection, sucks. Do I have instant? Yeah, I don't want him to get rid of my tutor. Thought Scare, yeah, whatever. Go ahead and get rid of Tassiger now. I think I'm okay with that. Go ahead and take out a threat now. Okay, let's see what he goes with. He goes with his Pluto Delta. So, let's Pithing Needle and see if he decides to counter it. I'm guessing yes. So I'll just use my second Pithing Needle. There's a Watery Grave. Yep. So, just when he thought it was safe to go outside. Alright, let's name... He's down one Pluto Delta, so we're okay there. Let's go with... Let's go with Flooded Strand. Is that what he had in hand? He had one Polluted... Oh, Scalding Tarn. Ooh, we can go with Scalding Tarn, so that's a dead card in his hand. What do I do versus main deck Worldbreaker? Shred It. Is a horrible card for us. You have to Pixis it. Alright, so we shut off one of his lands. So he's got an island in hand and a useless Tarn. Now he picked up Steam Vents. He's going to collect a Brutality, yes. Get rid of our tutor. Yep. That kind of hurts. So no more that. No more polluted delta. Ooh, stirrings is good. Why don't we start off with that? Let's see if we can find a lantern. Oh, there's a crucible. Ooh, Academy Ruins is fun. That would be fun to throw back and forth. Ew, I don't have a blue source, though. Crucible, I don't have a ghost quarter right now. No lantern. I think go with the Academy Ruins. Let's throw a shredder out. Let's go ahead and blind shred and see what we get. We get, ooh, Snapcaster. That's nice. All right, let's see. He plays his island. This is going to be... Oh, did he pull another Tassiger? Yep. Okay, he's got two cards in hand. We know it's a Tarn and a Scour. So I think we're good. Oh, two bridges. Okay. Did he draw another counter? Or is he going to Scour himself? Okay. He gets rid of a Tarn and another and a Dispel. Okay. That Dispel would have been nice for him. Oh, I guess I don't have any instants, really. Okay, so we have the bridge down, so we're good there. And we have a backup bridge already in hand. Let's go ahead and shred the top of his library. Let's see if we hit something. Oh, a command. That works. Oh, did he draw a frickin' command? Okay. Engineered explosives. Come on, pithing needle. Oh, collective brutality. I think we need to take a look and see what he's got in his hand now. I know he's got the Tarn. Let's see if he's got something else. Oh, he's got two commands. Okay. So, let's get rid of one of them. Okay, so engineered explosive is going to be horrible. Blind milling's okay. It's probably not our greatest of moves at the moment. Alright, so let's see if he blows up this bridge. Yep. Okay. So we're going to take our beats. Yeah, you do not blind mill yourself. Let's mill him. Oh, Ceremonious Rejection. I like hitting that. Stirrings. Do I stirrings or do I go for the bridge now? I had four needles, so I set it out one needle. And my dogs are going bananas. Okay, I think we lead on the stirrings. And we're looking for a blue source. Ooh, a glimmer void? That works. We can start bringing stuff back. So let's do the glimmer void. Let's throw out our bridge. And we are game on now. He's got a Thought Scour. Yeah. Yeah, he should have known. Alright, let's shred him. I got rid of a watery grave. Alright. Bell's not the greatest plays, but hey, it gives us another shredding. Alright, now we can start bringing stuff back with our ruins. So, well, all we have really is the needle and another bridge. From here, I would love a lantern. So, he can already crypt it because he can crack his delta and get another blue source. Yeah, really need a lantern. He's going to bounce something. He's going to bounce my bridge back. Yep. So I did what? Return and draw. Okay. So we're going to take a beats. Let's go ahead and shred. Got rid of a tarn. That's ghoul collar bell, which is okay. Oh, there's a lantern. Okay. We can bring that back. Yep. Hey, dogs, chill. Alright, so we're gonna take our beats. Alright, he's trying to dig real deep for a counter. Cryptic. We got rid of three cryptics. Only real thing we need to worry about for sure is that K command. A creeping tar pit is a play. Okay, well, let's bring back our lantern. So let's draw our lantern. Ooh, lightning bolt. Ooh. Let's play our bridge. We can't let him have a lightning bolt. I don't want to deal with that. Oh, he can have a tarn. We're good there. Let's pass the turn. I would say okay. I wouldn't say pretty good yet until I for sure get rid of some K commands. And then we'll be good. Alright, he can't attack. Can he... Let's see what he's got. He's got two cards in hand. Yeah, they've used three cryptics. He runs at least two K commands, though, is what I'm worried about. Okay, let's see. Trading for foil lantern pieces, so I was talking to someone on Facebook. Okay, oh, we cannot let him have a snapcaster. I forgot about snapcasters. Okay, so... Actually, no, we'll start out with a ghoul color because I really don't want a mox. Dispel, yeah, whatever. We have another lantern. What can I put on top? Do I want anything on top? Ooh, a pithing needle might be fun, but what do I put it on? We have it on tarn already. Does it matter? I don't think so. I guess lantern's okay. I mean, worst case scenario, we can use it to shuffle their library. counter target instant. I don't have any instants. Okay, so we'll let him draw. Ooh, there's a K command. Let's see if he cracks his Tarn to get that, though. Oh, no, he can't crack his Tarn. Ooh, I could just take it. Okay. Spell Snare, yeah, whatever. Collective Brutality. Could look at his hand. Do I need Collective Brutality? I don't think I do, because if he had a K command, he'd already played it. So let's just mill that away. Another Tasker. Oh, we have an Opal, so I'll play the Opal, I guess. Oh, there's the Shredder. Alright, pass the turn. He can have another Tasker. He's going to activate Tasker. He will activate Tasker, so let's give him Ceremonious Rejection. Oh, don't mill to their end of turn. Yeah, I know. Swamp. Serum Visions, we'll get rid of that. Yeah, but I didn't get it just because if he had something, he would have already played it. So I wasn't so worried about him having something in his hand at that point. Because I know for sure one of the cards is another Tasker. So, another Shredder, so we're doing good here. Let's use up, throw another one of these down. He'll probably counter it, whatever. Oh, he didn't, okay. I know I don't want him to have Snapcaster. Blood Crypt, he can have Blood Crypt. Yeah, he can chain Tasker together. I'm not super worried about it yet. It's definitely getting down there to where I need to start worrying. So we can only do it one at a time at the moment. So maybe I do bring the needle back and lock him out of Tasker. So let's give him let's give him Dispel. I know I definitely don't want him to have a K command again. I'm just doing all sorts of things to really tick you off, aren't I? Counter Squall. I think I'm okay with him having Counter Squall. Ew, Casting Vision does speed up my clocks. I guess he would draw three cards. Pixis. Do I want Pixis? Let's see what he's got. One command, two command. I think he's out of commands. I think I'll try and grab a needle real quick while I've got one. Yeah, my clock sucks right now. Under 5 minutes. Let's see if I can play a needle and see if he counters it. Yep. I lose 2 life. Yep. Yep, yep. Thought Scour. No, I don't want you to have Thought Scour because I don't want you to draw a card. I don't know. Counter Squall. That's fine. Here's another Cryptic. What's he creeping tar pit? Okay. Get on with your bad self in that creeping tar pit. Lightning Bolt? Yeah, no. Don't. Inventor's Fair on top. Oh, you start. Put my needle back on top. There's a Ceremonious Rejection. Alright, Lightning Bolt. I'm okay with him grabbing a Lightning Bolt, not worried about it at the moment. Because I'm at 6, not 3. Okay. Instep, let's shred him a little bit. Okay, so let's get back our pithing needle. Oh, do I care? No, let's get back our Pyxis so I can mill some more. Here comes Pyxis. He's going to counter this too. Yep. Oh, down to 4. There's a K command. Yeah, I'm kind of screwed on time. So let's get rid of his K command. Ooh, there's a Surgical. And let's get rid of our Opal. We have another Lantern. Let's see if we can get the Pyxis back. He's gonna get me. Yep. I think we've got it. Just, we're going to run out of time for game 3. Hit his other Surgical. Okay, so we're going to win because he can't draw, but we're screwed in game 3. Okay, well, just run it back out. This would have been a draw. And yeah, he's going to get this because of time. Now we have a bridge and a bell. That's about it. Let's get rid of that. Lost Legacy would be nice, but have any lands. Because I can name Surgical Extraction. I can name lots of things at that, but I don't have any lands to cast it. God. Okay, come on, land on top. I guess it doesn't matter. We're not getting done in 2 minutes. Well, there's my surgical. Not a land. Not a land. And he's a fellow lantern player. Okay. Still no land. Wow. Well, there was a inventor's fair. Oh, jeez. Okay. Well. Let's just get rid of the Thoughtseize. Land? Oh, it is a land. He surgically extracted my Thoughtseize. Okay. Alright, let's see what Inquisition reveals. Oh, Snapcaster, is he going to bring back... He's going to bring back a Surgical Extraction. Okay, so I guess there goes my Inventor's Fair. Nope. There go my Inquisitions, but eh, at this point. If I get a second land, I think we would have had a pretty good chance on this. Nope. Okay, well. I'll just do a lantern. There's our land. Ugh. Let me get rid of my land. Got K command. Oh, engine explosives on 3. Okay. Well, I can pithing needle that, so for what it's worth. Yep. We could scoop, but I might as well finish it at this point. Alright, she's gonna have Tassiger online next turn. And I need 2 lands. So why don't we just shuffle away my this and hope we hit a land. Ugh. Really, deck? Let's play our cage now. Turn this on. Maybe. Yeah. Just gonna scoop now, because he's gonna throw out Tassiger and we're toast. Oh, okay. Well, that would have been nice earlier. Out of time. Alright, well, that would have been a draw, but we'll go with it. Okay, let's play another match. So we've had Eldrazitron, which just ran over us. We've had Grixis Delver. Let's see what we're going against now. Could there be anything else that we could hit that I just hate playing against? I mean, Burn would be just tip of the iceberg. Okay, so we've got everything that we need except for everything. Ugh. No green mana for the stirrings. We do have a collective brutality. I think we keep it just because of Thoughtseize. Just to take a look and see what we're playing. Play Dark Slick. Let's play Bobble. Let's Thoughtseize. This white blue junk thing. Let's get rid of Secure the Waste. Okay. And I'll bobble in my end step on myself so I can see what I got going on. And just get a second card. All right, let's crack this. And Abrupt Decay. Well, that's definitely not super helpful at the moment. Pixis. Let's throw this out. Let's go ahead and see what he's got in his hand. Sphinx Revelations and Serum Visions. Let's go with... Do I care if he gains life? No. If he draws cards? No. It helps me out. Let's get rid of the Serum Visions. Alright, opponent, what do you got? He throws out a Celestial Colonnade. Okay. So that means he's got a Godless Shrine, a Supreme Verdict, and a Sphinx. Okay. Ooh, Ghost Quarter. That'll keep the Colonnade in check. Let's play our Pyxis. And I wonder if this is the time our opponent realizes I'm playing Lantern. Because Bauble doesn't quite give it away. But Pyxis just screams, I'm playing against Lantern. All right, opponent. Throw out your Godless Shrine. Untapped. Okay. I won't start using the Pyxis yet because I want to draw. That's a good draw. Their opponent draw a counter. Or is our opponent reading our cards? Okay. Still no green mana yet. What's our opponent going to do? Esper Charm? I'm assuming he drew two cards. Let's shred. Fatal Push, doesn't matter. Okay, so... What is our opponent up to? Another Colonnade. Well, There's an Opal, so there's our green source, which works. We can also Abrupt Decay a Colonnade when it comes online. So, Colonnades are covered. Ugh. Deck. Let's just get rid of the other Opal. Deck, what are you doing to me? Let's shred him again. There's an island. Okay. Colonnades take 5, yeah. So I'm not worried about those yet. Okay, deck. Come on. We'll gain some life. Another Stirrings is good. Come on, a Lantern. Be great. Oh, we have a Lantern, another Ghost Quarter, and a Bridge. I think we go with the Lantern. Alright. Now we know what we're playing with. Unless he counters. Cryptic. Okay. Let's shred him. There's a Polluted Delta. And our opponent has nothing to play this turn. Come on, Lantern. Oh, yes. I wonder what it feels like to cryptic command a lantern. Can't feel good about that. Oh, here's the second one. Okay. Well, he is dead set on us not getting a lantern. A nice pretty foil island. So he's still sitting on a Supreme Verdict and a Sphinx, so whatever. Okay, is he activating his Celestial Colonnade? Oh. Well, that's a card. Huh. Esper Control. Okay, so we are going to need a bridge quickly. Huh. Come on, bridge. Shredder. Nope, that's not gonna work. Well, that's a card I have to deal with now. I think Fair's going to have to go bye-bye so we can get a bridge. Well, yep. Got rid of a charm. Take our beats from the tokens. See what he plays. More tokens? Okay, gotta sack it. I don't know why he didn't try to kill our Inventor's Fair to start. Oh, I guess he doesn't have ghost quarters. Never mind. Let's grab a bridge. There, Blooming Marsh. Okay, we can play that. We'll play our Shredder just to get our hand down. Let's try the bridge. This is our last shot. Because, I mean, he's going to run us over with tokens. And snaps back. Cryptic. Yep. Yep. Okay. Well. Let's shred away. Path Exile. Another Esper Charm. So we're going to take some beats. Bridge. Nope. Ghost Quarter. Yep. Nope. Let's call it a game. Okay, Esper. We could possibly see Stony Silence. So I'll bring in another Abrupt Decay just because. Lost Legacy to remove the Cryptics. Pandine because it'll take out the tokens. And Graph Diggers because it'll shut off Snapcaster. So let's get rid of I don't think baubles are needed. Pithing Needle, we can do the Colonnade and the Elspeth are the other ones. So I think we can go down one needle. Oh, don't need a Crucible. I think that's just too slow. And what else? Let's go down one bridge, because if we shut off Elspeth, we don't have to worry about creatures too much. So let's try this. Yes, I will play first. All right, we have a Lantern, Thoughtseize, and a Pithing Needle. We are pretty good in business with this one. So let's start out with Botanical Sanctum, Lantern of Insight, Stony. Well, we can not Thoughtseize that away. Gah. Okay, well, we can lay down our Pithing Needle before Stony comes out at least. Oh, I guess he's not activated, so never mind. That does shut off our Ghoul Caller spell, though. So it's not the end of the world, but it's definitely not a good thing. Little does our opponent know that we have no black mana. So, let's throw a Ghost Quarter down. Let's throw the Pithing Needle. Let's needle Sun's Champion. And let's throw out a Ghoul Caller's Bell. Okay, so at least we shut off Elspeth. And here comes Stony. Do I? I think I let it go through because I want this Blooming Marsh. Stony Silence isn't horrible. It's definitely harder to win, but it's not like I'm playing. Not like I'm playing against. Oh, I just used the wrong thing. Dang it. I meant to use Inquisition. Oh, Lingering Souls and Esper Charm. Well, let's get rid of Lingering Souls for what it's worth. It's not like I'm playing Affinity. Affinity is pretty much destroyed by Stony Silence. I should know I played Affinity a lot. Okay. Marsh Flats for our opponent. Oh. So we'll take the Pithing Needle. Oh, there's a bridge. That'll work. Well, Pithing Needle, naming this Celestial Colonnade. So now the only beats that can come are going to be from Snapcaster. Oh, I guess Lingering Souls. But if we can go empty-handed, we are good to go. So I know he's got a cryptic command, so when I try to cast this Ensnaring Bridge, he's going to take it out. But that's okay, he hasn't seen that we've had Abrupt Decays. And I think I brought in the Seal. There's a Spire. Not super helpful. This is when I wish I would have started out with Inquisition, because I get Thought Seize Away is cryptic at this point. So let's just see if he tries to counter it for some odd reason. Academy of Ruins really gets around Cryptic Command. He's probably asking himself, why didn't he play the Inquisition first? And he would have a good point. Okay, something's up. Okay, yep. Is he cryptic commanding now? What? He's drawing. This is confusing. So he drew a Think Twice and an Esper Charm. Now he can still bounce my bridge, but it just goes back to my hand. Well, let's get rid of Mana Leak, because I hate Mana Leak. I'm not worried about a second Stony Silence, because whatevs. Yeah, let's get rid of that. And then he can bounce this, I guess. That was a rather odd play by our opponent, but okay. So here comes the cryptic. But that just goes back to our hand. Okay, he's holding on to cryptic, so we'll draw the spire. And just pass. Flashes back, Think Twice. Digs for what? Godless Shrine, okay. Well, our opponent is definitely getting his mana that he needs. I just don't know what he's doing. Here's flashing back. Think twice again. Okay. So our opponent has no threats. I don't know what he's doing. Is he holding his back for some reason? I don't know. I'm confused. Let's throw this out just because. So we can look twice. I'm really confused at our opponent's play. Like, very confused about our opponent's play. Well, there's an abrupt decay, but he has a cryptic in hand. So if I remember right, I think I did bring in the seal, the other abrupt decay, and a nature's claim. So we've got four ways to get rid of this stony silence. Secure the waste. Okay. Going to bounce something? No? What? Okay. He sphinxes for three. And we see that he drew a flooded strand, a serum visions, and a logic knot. Okay. He draws his island. I honestly don't know what he's digging for. Because if we get a Padim, it's going to be hilarious. Because then he can't bounce anything. And he doesn't have any way to take it out. I guess Path to Exile, but I think he is going to get rid of them because he knows that we don't have any creatures. Ooh, a detention sphere. Yuck. Okay. Well, that'll definitely take out our ensnaring bridge. And there's a second stony. Collective brutality is nice. We'll hold this abrupt decay for now. Well, he's casting something. What's he casting? Secure the waste. Okay, well, we'll get rid of one stony silence for now since he tapped out. Green and black. Okay. So we're going to take our beats because he's going to spear this ensnaring bridge, which I came to expect, and we're going to get pinged forward a time, which kind of sucks, but eh. Trying to think. Collect brutality. I think we just kill a token. I don't think there's anything in this hand that I really care about. I think this is our slow death, unless I can get another bridge and play around his cryptic and his other counters, because he's got that logic knot and he's got a cryptic. It's okay, I guess, if he counters his the bridge, because we have Academy Ruins still. Man, our opponent is a really slow player. Good grief. Overall matchup win. Do we have this Esper Control? Oh, we do. It looks like it's just a barely winning percent. Okay. 7-5 for matches. Well, unless I draw a bridge, I think it's going to go to 7-6. What's our opponent doing? Oh, another. Oh, that's awesome. I think we just go ahead and destroy the colonnade just because. And our opponent goes to grab a land card. So if we don't draw a bridge this turn, we're done. Well, after this. So, yep. And that's Esper Control. Alrighty. Alright, one more before I don't want to end on an Esper Control match. We are 0-3 tonight. Some horrible, horrible matchups. Alright, so I will play first. We've got the lantern. We have a stirrings. Oh, this isn't too bad. We'll try. Opal. And we'll throw our lantern. And starings next time. Oh, we've got a bridge. Oh, we're playing Delver. Oh, what is this? Oh, good heavens. All I need is burn, and I have hit the most decks that I don't want to see ever again. Those players' strengths. See if we can get something. We already have a lantern. Ugh, really? Awesome. Okay, well, at least our Opal's online for bridge next time. Huh. My deck hates me tonight. It's saying give up and go watch the 100. Or Arrow, or both. I could watch both. We take a one. I'm up to 20 viewers. Oh, hey. I think that's the most I've ever had at one time, so welcome, welcome. So let's do Ghost Quarter into a bell. And let's try throwing our bridge down. I don't think he's got a counter. We'll see. He might. Ooh, our Academy Range is on top, so we're good there. Does our opponent have the counter? Yes, he does. Okay. Like I said, our Academy Range is on top, so I'm okay with that. He does not flip the Delver. And we're back down to 3 viewers. I wonder if we hit something real quick. That was weird, but whatever. Okay. We're going to take our beating of 1. We'll grab our ruins, and then we'll ghoul callers based on what's underneath it. Because I really don't want to see that spell queller. Oh, yeah. We can get rid of the Dark Slick Shores. I'm okay doing that. So, we'll Abrupt Decay this. Oh, no, I don't want to. Do I want to do that? Black and green. 1, 2, 4. Yeah, we're good. Okay, so black and green. Get rid of this Delver. We'll pass the turn, stop on his upkeep, and ghoul caller out the spell queller. Goodbye, spell queller. Lightning Helix, I'm okay with that. We'll bring back our bridge after this. Though there is a stirrings on top. I don't mind having a stirrings. We'll take the stirrings. I can always get the bridge back. Ooh, collect brutality too. Ooh. Didn't realize my screen was so big you can't see my deck list, so I'll move it over. Alright. Main phase. Stirrings. Lantern, a pithing needle, a ghost quarter, and a blooming marsh. So options are crappy and crappy. Well, guess we can grab another ghost quarter. And we'll just go on the smash and grab. Smash and grab plan. Now there's an inventor's fair. We'll keep that on top. We can then let him have serum visions. Lightning helix. Okay, whatever. Get on with your bad self. He'll grab the serum. I know he's got another Delver in hand, so I don't know what he's doing. He is definitely not a very aggressive player. Oh, for good heavens, another lantern on top of our deck. Oh, deck, you just don't like me tonight. Is he going to play his Delver finally? Yep. Which is fine. We are going to get rid of this lantern anyway. Ugh. Really? Let's put the bridge back on top. Alright, so bridge is on top. Let's see if we get it down or if he's going to counter it in some fashion. As we start gaining some life. Alright, here we go, bridge. He cracks his flooded strand. Pulls out another hallowed fountain. And does... Okay. Alright. Well, I definitely don't want to draw a spire, so why don't I ghoul caller myself? And... This deck hates me. Wonder how many basics does he run? So I get an Adventurer's Fair for another bridge. So I'm good with that. So that is what I will do. I'll Inventor's Fair. Tapping that, that, and that. Go grab me a bridge. Play my runes. Choose to keep the one that's not tapped. And then let's play the bridge. Alright, so there we go. We got out of that. Okay, Delver does not flip. Snapcaster is going to get nothing of any importance. And we have a Pithing Needle on top, so that's pretty useless. Let's see what our opponent does. He draws his Flooded Strand. Puts a Vapor Snag I could care less about. Plays his Flooded Strand. Grim Lavamancer. Well, there's a nice Pithing Needle target. I didn't know main deck Grim Lavamancers were in Delver. But, okay. So let's see what our opponent does. Let us Pithing Needle the Lavamancer. He cracks his Flooded Strand. Let's see what he grabs. I'm really tempted to start destroying his white. Oh, well, never mind. I think he was afraid I was going to name the Flooded Strand. But given a Flooded Strand or a Grim Lavamancer, I think it's a pretty easy guess. Pass turn. Alright, so we're in pretty good shape. I'm trying to think of what he could possibly have that would beat me. Beat this hand. Path to Exile is not going to do anything. Because we got to start drawing our Shredders. I mean, just based on how many cards we have left. So here's the first one. Inquisition, I don't care about that. Alright, so play a Shredder. Pass the turn. We can let him have that Path to Exile because there are no targets for it. Flips the Delver. Again, don't care. Oh, I guess he chooses not to flip the Delver. So, okay. Spell Quiller on top. We'll go ahead and start doing some shredding. Get rid of that. Steam Vents. You know what? I'll draw Inquisition because I just kind of am curious to see what he's got in his hand. He's got four cards. I just don't know what they are. And if it's a Remand, I can cast Inquisition again using my Opal. So it's not terrible if he does Remand it back to my hand. And that's what he's got. Snapcaster. Remand. Do I care? care about Snapcaster any. What can he recast? Electrolyze? Eh. Lightning Helix? Eh. Remand? You know what? I'll take the Snapcaster. I don't care if it counters something. I've got enough mana that I'm not worried about holding it in my hand for too long. Alright. So our opponent does what? He path to exiles his own Delver. Okay. Why? So now he's got a Steam Vent, a Spell Snare, and a Remand. Let's just shred him a little bit. Do I need another Pithing Needle? I don't think so. I need to get down to... Ooh, there's another bell. That'll work. And he tries to remand it. I'll just cast it again. Oh, he does not. Okay. I think our opponent is starting to feel that you know, when you get that lockdown and just can't do anything about it, I think he's getting to that point. Let's get rid of the Snapcaster. Let's get rid of the Lightning Bolt. Let's get... Ooh, Collector Brutality. Oh, yep. He gives up. Okay, there we go. Alright, so now we got... I think Padim would be good. We have Lost Legacy. We have Graft Diggers. So we'll go down the Baubles. We'll go down a Pithing Needle, because really there's not too many targets. And we'll go down... We'll keep an Abrupt Decay just in case he's got a Stony in there. I think we go down... Huh, he's not going to have anything big, so I think we go down a... Well, his Cryptics would be... Nice fodder for Thoughtseize if he's running them. Yeah, I think we go down to Thoughtseize. We're good there. Alright. Game 2. Against Grixis Delver. Well, I guess not really Delver. Grixis Delver. Not Grixis. Esper? Is that red, white, and blue? Jeskai. Jeskai Delver. Ooh, we have a Padim. And an Ancient Stirrings. Oh, I think we're okay keeping this since we're on the draw. It could be fun. I've never actually played a Padim, so it'd be nice to actually test it. So I just wanted to say hey to everybody that's watching along. Feel free to comment down here in the chat if you have any comments. I'm a relatively new Lantern player, so... I'm making all sorts of stupid mistakes, it appears to be. So feel free to comment, do whatever. But thanks for watching. Okay, so now we've got... I think we need to save the Glimmer Void just in case he kills our Lantern. So let's go with Ghost Quarter and playing our Lantern so we can start seeing our opponent's deck. All right, that's a Lightning Bolt. Alright, so I think the plan next time is to throw Glimmer Void, then go into an Ancient Stirrings. Our opponent plays a Stony Silence, okay. I kind of figured that. So, let's go with Glimmer Void, Ancient Stirrings. Let's see what we can grab. Ugh. Well, let's go with... Ooh, Crucible might be fun, so we can start doing some Ghost Quartering. I think Crucible is what it is, since we can't go with the Stony Silence issue at the moment. So that might be some fun. Okay, let's throw down a bell. No, I can't use it, but that's fine. Next turn, I'll throw down the Grove, and then we'll go to work with the Crucible. Shortly after that, we have the Ruins in hand, too. So, I mean, we have a pretty good... We could do a Landlock game. I haven't done one of those in a really long time. That was actually with my 8-rack deck that I played. A Johnny? What is a Johnny going to do? Deals 3 damage to target creature or player and gain 3 life. Okay, destroy all lands. Well, that would suck. He can't cast it at the moment. So I think we're okay there. So let's play Grove of the Burn Willows. Let's see. Do I go ahead and... Oh, there's an Inquisition on top. Maybe... I'll hold off on Crucible until I can Ghost Quarter next turn. Maybe I do my Collective Brutality now and see what's in his hand. I think that's our play. So I really want him to get rid of this Flooded Strand so I know he's going to grab so that I can start destroying a single color. So I'll see if he's got that fourth land so he can play a Johnny. Oh, he does not have the fourth land. Cryptic, Lightning Bolt, Helix, Spell Queller. Wonder why he didn't play Spell Queller. Oh well, whatever. Get rid of that. Alright. Ooh, he's still coming up short on lands. Geist of Saint Traff, though, is going to suck. Spell Queller would suck for Crucible, though. Well, I think we Inquisition and try for the Spell Queller. And then... Barring that... Oh, any scoops? That was kind of a little premature, but hey, I'll take it. All right, so we're good there. That was a short one. So we'll go one more match. So that was our first win of the night. I think our opponent just got frustrated with us, which is fine. That's part of the fun of the deck. All right. Ooh, a draw first again. Oh, we got a Lantern. We got a Bauble. We have Stirrings. Ooh, this is actually pretty decent. We'll keep this. All right, homie C. Let's see what you got. I can actually turn on my opal. So, throw that. Throw that. Throw that. Throw that. Throw that. Dismember. What? Ancient Strings. Let's take a... Academy Ruins? Or Inventor's Fair. Or a Glimmer Void. No, we don't need Void. Let's go with the Academy Ruins. Throw those away. And... Pass the turn. Alright, let's see what our opponent's playing. Is this Eldrazi? Really? Really? Does everybody just play this now? Okay. So, we'll... Ruins down. We'll Abrupt Decay this Expedition map just to slow our opponent down. Throw down an Opal to replace itself. And throw down a Ghoul Caller's Bell. Let him have that waste. But I mean, really? Walking ballista. Ugh. Well, I will take my two cards. So, Bobble. Oh, what is it with the opals? Good heavens. Oh, well, there's an ensnaring bridge. Though I'm going to have to mill it, but that's fine. Well, Inquisition. Get rid of the Matter Reshaper, because Dismember does nothing against us. And does our opponent have Tron in hand already? Oh, no, he's got a Temple, a Waste, and a Ghost Quarter. We definitely don't want him to get a Ballista. Oh, so let's give him an Endbringer. Awesome. Okay. Well, here's hoping for a Needle. There's a Mine. Can't play anything yet, so we're okay there. Okay. So he is bored. I'm sorry. Okay. Well, you get on with your bad self then. All right. So, since that guy, you know, too boring for him. And I'm offline. Huh. So, okay. Anyway, I'll keep playing because I'm still recording. Oh, there we go. There we pop on. Okay, so we've got a Bobble, we have Thoughtseize, Collective Vitality. I think we're okay keeping this. It's not the greatest. So play the Marsh, play the Bobble, play the Thoughtseize so we can see what we're up against. Oh, okay. Red, black, something. Okay, so I think we get rid of the Vexing Devil. Cause that just seems horrible. Opponent goes with a Mountain, and I'm assuming the Bowmat Carrier. Yep. I've actually not seen Bowmat Carrier used a whole lot, so. And he exiles the top of his deck, which is actually okay for us. We have no blockers, and I need another card. So I'll crack this Bobble. And I'll take a look at my deck and see what's going on. Ugh, deck. Why do you do this to me? Oh, really? Okay, that Collective Brutality would be nice against the Carrier. I mean, Courier, but that requires a second land. Oh, man. Alright, let's see what our opponent does. Plays Temple of Malice. Didn't have that card before. He's going to play a Lightning Bolt. Goes to attack. exiles a card. Play your lightning bolt. Come on. He does not. Okay. Well, we'll shred. Let's see what we grab. Foreboding ruins. Alright. Land. No land. Yet again. Inquisition. So I think the only thing I really care about is. Excuse me, is that bushwhacker? He's gonna bolt me. Okay, whatever. Yep, bushwhacker down. So, man, couple lands is all we need. Shred him. Another foreboding ruins. Okay, we're 2 for 2 on foreboding ruins. See what our opponent does. We know he's got nothing really in hand I'm worried about. There's a mountain. And he's got a Hellspark Elemental. Well... okay. That was a good draw. So we'll take 4 to the face. All right, deck. Gotta start playing nice. Ugh. I hate you. I hate you, deck. Just when you think it would work, it doesn't. Gonna sack his Bowmat. He does not. Okay. So we'll shred him again. Can we not shred a land? Please? Record tonight is 1-3. I don't count that one that Eldrazi guy just played scooping. Since really I had him in a lock. Or almost had him in a lock, so he was toast. But, yep. And the Hellspark Elemental comes back, so we're going to take another 4. I think if we don't get a land, we're pretty much screwed at this point. Okay, deck. There goes the courier. I've had a really string of bad luck tonight. He's got a bolt. Oh. That's awesome. No. So we are going to take at least 4 next turn. Land? Okay. I think we have to abrupt decay this. Okay, he's got 3 cards in hand. 1 is a swamp, 1 is a fatal push. Oh no, he dumped those. Never mind. So I don't know what he's got. A foreboding ruins. That's 3 out of our 4 shreds have been foreboding ruins. All right, opponent, what you got? a Reckless Imp with Dash and a Bomat Courier. Okay. And do we have something else? Yep. And that's game. Oh, man. Deck. Yeah. Okay, so bring in our ley lines. Oh, what else? Pyroclasm. I think the Aether Grid would be fine. I think Battle at the Bridge would be fine. Sun Droplet would be nice. Think we're good there. Let's go down the baubles. Let's go down. There's nothing to needle in this matchup outside of Courier, which we'll leave two just in case. And we'll go down the Crucible, and we'll go down. See, do I need to worry anything about Abrupt Decay with this deck? Probably not. I'll keep one just in case. We'll go down to Thoughtseize so we don't burn ourselves. Okay. Game two. I'll play first. Ley line. Don't have anything else, but we got a ley line. Perform any opening hand actions. There you go. Upkeep. Ruins. Shredder. We have three shredders. So we can really go to town. We don't have anything else to cast since we have no colored mana. Okay. Let's start shredding. Oh, Lightning Berserker? Okay. This is some like weird dash thing. Bomat Carrier? Courier? Oh, there's a lantern. That's a good. Okay. Throw the lantern. Throw the ghoul callers. Yeah, we can't let him have a Lightning Berserker since it's basically a pumpable creature that sucks with dash. So we'll just get rid of that now. Lightning, can't do anything about it. Can't touch us. I don't think there's any way that he can destroy enchantments. Infernal Tutor, we can not cast that, actually. Okay. Lightning Berserker. Okay. We have no black mana. So even though we have a ley line, we have no mana to cast anything else. So we'll draw a tutor. There's a spire. That'll work next time. Get our Pyxis. We can let him have a swamp, because that at least doesn't boost up his Berserker. There's a Reckless Bushwhacker. Well, that's our opponent got. Ambuscade Shaman. Ugh. Okay. At least it's not dashed. we need to keep him off of creatures. This is some kind of weird dash deck. So we know we exiled the bushwhacker, which is fine. Reckless Imp. We can't let him have that because that can come in dashed. And we don't want it a 4/4. Duress. Don't want him to have duress either. So let's play our Spire. Let's shred the duress. Oh, a bushwhacker. Okay. Let us thought seize. Because we can tutor up a bridge next turn. There's a shaman. He has to hard cast it. Not right there. The stuff to the face doesn't work, so we'll just take the shaman. Do I want to get rid of a swamp? I think we're going to have to get rid of the swamp. Just because I can't afford to have a bushwhacker. Well, it can't be surged in. So, do I care? I think it's okay. Because it can't be surged in. So he's hurting for mana. Which is fine, because once I land a bridge, it's game over. Unless he's got a disenchant, well, not a disenchant, but a smash to smithereens. Which would suck. And I'm going to take 4, which is okay. Oh, he has haste. I didn't even think about that. Well, that's a dumb move on my part. 4, 6, 7, 8. Yep. I think I'm dead next turn because I'm an idiot. Yep, I screwed that up, so I deserve this. Well, yep. So, I think we Ghoul Caller, because we're looking for a bridge. We Shred. That's not going to work. We Pixis. And that's game. Jeez. Okay, I think with that screw up, it's time for me to go watch some TV or something and relax and not play anymore. So thank you all for viewing. I will go ahead and post this to my YouTube channel. I will post that in the Facebook page, but thank you all, and I will start streaming again later. Thanks.